Hello, my lovely friends. My name is Ava, and today I'm going to be giving you a Tiffany Roberts binging reading vlog. I'm actually going to be on a live show very soon in 4 days with Tiffany Roberts and Jen from The Book Refuge and Jessen from Jessen Reads Romance. We're all going to be on a live show together. And so I'm so excited. We're basically going to be chatting with Tiffany Roberts and everything. I'm so excited. but if you didn't know, Tiffany Roberts is an author duo, a husband-wife author duo that I am really excited to meet even virtually. And this live show has probably already happened at this point. So I'm going to link it down below if you want to go back and watch it. But I decided up until the live show, I'm going to be binging some of their books. So first, I am reading His Darkest Craving. Oh, my phone is at 1%. Oopsie. This is their like paranormal-esque romance where I think the heroine is being like abused by an ex. And he's about to be released from jail. And she goes to hide out in the woods in like a new cabin in the woods so he doesn't find her. And I think like this entity, like I don't think it's like a solid form that lives in the forest, has like been watching her, and then they like get together possibly, but it's very vague. My phone is at 1%, so I can't really read the summary for you right now. I've only read like a couple of pages so far, and I'm really enjoying it. I'm hoping on reading Ensnared and possibly one other book by them in this vlog, but I wanted to introduce the vlog, and I'm really excited. Tiffany Roberts is one of my favorite author duos. I really love their works. Some of their favorites that I've read is Make Me Burn. I really love Dust Walker. That one's a post-apocalyptic romance. And then I also really liked is the first book called Ensnared? I like the first book in the Spider's Mate trilogy. I forget what it's called. Maybe I got them mixed up, book one and two. But I really want to read book two for this video. If I messed up the title earlier, I really want to read book two in the Spider's Mate series. There you go. We'll see how many books I read. I've been very slow with my reading that is an audiobook right now. And so I really am liking their His Darkest Craving. So I don't, hopefully this isn't the only book that I read for this vlog, but it might be. We will see. But we'll just see how much of their books I can read before their live show. Okay, everyone. So I have downloaded the audiobook for His Darkest Craving, and I'm really liking it so far. The narrator is really great. Also, sorry if I'm keeping my voice low. I am currently staying with my parents over winter break, and so I'm currently sitting in the bathroom. So I have to be quiet because they're sleeping. But I really am liking this so far. Our heroine Sophie just got introduced to and met our forest entity. His name is Cruz, and apparently he was cursed by a fae queen to be a to not have physical form, and he could only have his physical form on Hallow's Eve, so on Halloween. And so Halloween is a couple days away, and he's like counting down the days to get his physical form so he can have Sophie, because that's what he wants Sophie. If you are affected at all by domestic violence, I don't know if this one should be for you, because Sophie is very traumatized by it and has PTSD. Her ex-husband would beat her a lot, and so that's discussed in here, and she's running away from her ex in this book, and she's terrified and petrified that he will find her and he will show up and do horrible things to her again. So she's constantly paranoid, and that's why she moved to this cabin in the middle of nowhere in hopes that her ex will not find her. But our entity Cruz lives in this forest, and so he can scent Sophie, and normally he kills and takes the life force of any human that he comes across. But then when he comes in contact with Sophie, he realizes that he doesn't hunger for her in like the normal sense. He hungers for her in a different sense, if you know what I mean. I'm very intrigued by this. It's very interesting reading about how he tries to make himself kind of like a physical form, but he can't yet until Halloween. The part that I just finished, chapter 3, and they just met in the woods, and he like revealed himself to her, and he saved her life from this bear. She was a little freaked out, but I hopefully think she's gonna be kind of like grateful for him, because he told her like, I will protect you from anything that harms you in this forest. And so I have an inkling that the ex might show up at the house and he might save her. It's really weird because you wouldn't expect a romance between a human woman and this just like entity being, like it doesn't even have a physical form, to be hot. But so far, like,
It's hot. Like, I don't know how Tiffany Roberts does it, but it's hot so far and they haven't even done anything. Anyway, I have to get ready for bed, and then before I fall asleep, I will be listening to more of the audiobook. I forgot to mention, the audiobook is on Audible, so that's where I got it. Unfortunately, this is gonna be the last audiobook by Tiffany Roberts that I haven't listened to yet, so I don't have any of their audiobooks to listen to after this, because I've listened to all the other ones they've made. So that's sad, but I hope they make more. I hope they make more audiobooks. I don't know, maybe that's something we need to talk to them about or ask them on their live show, because I feel like the Spider's Mate trilogy would be awesome as an audiobook series, but yeah. Anyways, I'm gonna go jump in the shower and then continue reading when I'm done.
Hi everyone, I'm here with Miss Katniss. Can you say hi again? And then there's Ollie crying like a baby. Come here, baby. Anyway, so it is the next day. I just finished His Darkest Craving by Tiffany Roberts. It's about to be noon. And I just finished this book. And I surprisingly loved this. I think I was just like really hesitant because I'm like, how is this entity and this woman gonna be together? And it was hot. Like, you wouldn't think that a spirit entity thing that has no physical form could be in a hot romantic relationship, and it was fun. The audiobook narrator is really good. I really recommend it. I did find his voice of Sophie, because it's a male narrator, his Sophie voice, like the heroine, her voice did make me chuckle a few times, because it just did. But overall, I really loved the audiobook. I did look on their like Goodreads to see which books I haven't read yet that might be like shorter in length, because I'm not trying to read one of their 300 plus page books right now. So I did find a novella by them that was only 99 cents. Oh my gosh, Ollie keeps crying. I will let you out in a second, buddy. It was a 99 cent audiobook. Not audiobook, ebook, and it's only like 50 pages long. It's called Icebound. I don't know anything about this, but I did have some digital credits. If you don't know, whenever you check out from Amazon and you're buying something from Amazon, it like gives you the dates of when you want your package. And most people say like, I want my package as soon as possible. But if you are able to like put it off for a couple days, like if it's not a priority mail thing, there's an option for you to get like a credit if you like. That's hard to explain. Basically, if you don't want your package as soon as possible, like you can wait an extra week or two and you click that option, it says below it, you will get a $1 or $2 digital credit. And so you can literally get paid to wait longer for your package. So I had a few digital credits, so I was like, why not get this one? Okay, the summary for this one says, Anna knows the loss and pain that can be wrought by winter's harshness intimately. For years, she's isolated herself, refusing to let go of the guilt that consumes her, until the winds of a blizzard bring a stranger to her door. With his compelling tales and heated kisses, Anna fears she hasn't only opened her home to him, but also her heart. It says it also includes the bonus story, The Winter King. I'm excited. I love wintry stories. It's currently pretty cold here in Texas because a cold front came through. That's why I'm bundling up. Anyway. So I'm gonna get started on this, and the cover is really pretty, so I'm gonna go let this crying dog out and then get started on this.
Hey guys, it's me and Oreo. Oreo, say hi. This is my cat. We have many pets here, if you couldn't tell. Anyway, so this is a photo booth update. I'm currently laying in bed editing videos, so I was like, why not update right now. I did finish another Tiffany Roberts book. I finished, what's the freaking title? I'm not good with titles. It's called Icebound. It's a novella that's like, there's like 40 pages in this novella, 30 of those pages is Icebound, and then the last 10 is a short story called The Winter King. Don't you just love this angle? Okay, so basically, Icebound is about this woman who is a widow, and she lost her husband and her baby girl. Like, her baby was recently born, a couple months old, to a horrible winter storm. And it's 5 years later, and she kind of has been living in the same cabin in the middle of nowhere in the icy snow, kind of like punishing herself for surviving when the rest of her family didn't. And so she lives out here by herself, a very lonely existence in the snow, and with only her and a cat, which is very sad. And then one day during the snowstorm that's really bad, she sees this figure out in the snow that comes knocking on her door asking for shelter, and it's a man named what is his name? Sorry, I'm pulling it up. Neladrim. It's a very interesting name. It's Anna and Neladrim. He ends up staying for the day, and he kind of helps her come to grips with her grief and helps her, like, learn more about herself and how, like, just because they're gone doesn't mean she can't move on with her life, and, like, this is not the life that her family wanted from her. And then they end up having a very passionate time together. And he may or may not be a snow being. Like, he's a snow being. Like a magical creature. Anyway, and then The Winter King is a little novella at the end of it. I guess it's like a short story, a part of a different anthology that they did. But basically, The Winter King is about Anna and Neladrim telling this story to this inn of people about the Winter King, who was the king of this winter realm, and he ends up kidnapping the Princess of Summerland, keeps her in his castle, and she ends up falling in love with him, kind of like Beauty and the Beast retelling. And so they tell the very entertaining story of that. And there's another few characters in there too, but that's the main part of that story that I really liked. I thought that was really interesting. Like, it doesn't tell you that it's Anna and Neladrim at the beginning. It just tells you that this couple is telling this story to this group of people. And I'm like, they kind of seem like the couple that we just read about. And then at the end, like, I don't want to spoil it. It's literally 10 pages a story. So, like it doesn't really matter. But it is them telling the story. And I thought it was really cute. I think I'm going to give this 4 stars. Like I do wish there was more to it. But especially the little novella. Like, the whole thing is a novella. The 10-page novella that Anna and Neladrim, like, told the story of. Like, the Winter King part. Where he, like, steals the Summer Princess. Like, I want that whole book. Like, I want that whole book right now. Like, that needs to be a whole book that they write, because that would be amazing. Like, I want that. I want that really badly. So, I really liked this. And I don't know what next book I'm going to pick up by them. We will see. I'm going to see if any of their other books are around novella length, because that's all I can really muster at the moment if it's not an audiobook. Unfortunately. Anyway, Oreo, you want to say goodnight? No. Okay.
So I just started a new Tiffany Roberts book. I started Undying, which is like the 7th book in, I think, a series. Like, all of them are written by different authors. And so I think Tiffany Roberts has written the 7th book, and I think also the 12th book. It says that you can read it on its own, that you don't need to read the other books in the series to understand this book at all. And so that's what I'm doing. It's only like 180 something pages, and the live show is tomorrow. And so hopefully I can read it by then. I'm 13% of the way through it. So far, it's very interesting. I'm a little confused, just a little bit, but I think you're going to be at the beginning of any alien romance story. So this one is an alien romance, and our heroine, she was in jail, or like, I don't know how to describe it. I think it's like a space jail. Like, they were all these women prisoners were on a spaceship together in space as a jail. It crashes on this planet, and our heroine Quinn, like, wakes up alone surviving this crash. And she's walking around, and she comes across this abandoned city, and there's a bunch of these, like, kind of like gargoyle colored statues, but they're like of like these creatures. And she's really interested in them because when she lived on Earth before she was put in prison, was a sculptor. And so she's admiring these sculptures, and then she comes across one, and I think she accidentally breaks one, and inside of it, like, the statue, I think, was like hollow on the inside, and inside of it there's this glowing blue and green stone. All of a sudden, this big alien comes, asks for the stone. Like, they don't understand each other at all, but he's like gesturing at the stone. She gives him the stone, and he kind of like takes her along to his home to take care of her. They don't speak the same language, so there's a language barrier, which is one of my favorite tropes ever. I love language barriers. But they're slowly starting to learn each other's language, and so that is the part that I'm at right now. I don't know what else happens, but I think they're probably mates, because she does have, I think it's called heterochromia. I may be totally wrong. So one of her eyes is green and one of them is blue, which is the same color as his stone. And his stone is called a heart stone. So when he took the stone, I forgot to say, when he took the stone from her, like a cavity opened up in his chest and he put the stone inside of it. And that's called his heart stone. So I think he's been searching for his heart stone for years and didn't know it was inside the statue. And so then he comes across her holding his stone. And I think that's his mate. That's just my theory. So I'm really liking it so far. I've been watching Disney movies. So I'm gonna watch some Disney movies while reading. I have to always be listening to something when I'm reading. I can't focus. But I did just make some cookies. I'm trying to get into my chronic illness and celiac related, gluten-free related channel on YouTube. And so I decided to make some gluten-free cookies and video how to make them and everything. So this is what they look like. They kind of look like chocolate meringue cookies, but I just call them my chocolate chewy cookies. They're really yummy. If you want to know the recipe to that, go follow my celiac and chronic illness channel down below. It's called the Chronically Ill Celiac. So I'm going to be making that video, editing that video very soon. And I just took my last batch out of the oven. So that's what I've been doing. So I'm going to get to reading. Hi guys. It's actually Saturday and the live show has already happened. I meant to do this whole clip, like a bunch of these clips talking about like how excited I was for the live show and film myself before the live show and getting ready for it and all that jazz, and like my plans were completely shot, like they are with a lot of people who deal with chronic illnesses. If you didn't know, I had a really big horrible flare-up episode with my chronic illness, the worst I've ever had in my entire life, a couple days before Christmas. And so I'm still slowly recovering from it. It's been a very slow process, and this morning I woke up incredibly dizzy. Like, even if I sat up a little bit out of bed, whole room spinning, could not see straight. It was not fun. And so I messaged Jen and I was like, just so you know, I'm having a little bit of a flare up right now. I haven't fainted today yet, but like, I'm feeling incredibly dizzy. And if I can't make it to the live show tonight, I am so sorry. I don't know how I'm gonna feel because I woke up in the morning and the live show wasn't until 6 p.m. And so she was of course super understanding and super sweet, and I love her for that. And she was like, of course, put your health first. And so I really wanted to do it though, because I love Tiffany Roberts and I love their books, and I just thought this was an amazing opportunity, and I felt honored and really wanted to talk to them. I spent all day laying down. I read up to like 50% of Undying, and I think I'm gonna finish it up for this vlog. That'll be like my last clip of the vlog. It's probably gonna be me wrapping up the book, because I had planned on finishing it before the live show, but unfortunately that did not happen, because if you don't know me with my chronic illness, I don't read a lot when I have a flare up or I don't feel well. I'm normally veg out on the couch watching a show where my mind doesn't have to work all that much, because I can get dizzy sometimes reading, especially on my phone or my iPad. So and even worse than a physical book. So anyway, I'm not gonna go into that. But I didn't feel well and I had a horrible migraine all day long. It's just now starting to dissipate and it's 1 a.m. I planned on finishing Undying today. That did not happen. But I am enjoying what I'm like reading so far from it. My plan on today was driving to my college town, which was an hour away, borrowing one of my parents' cars, driving to my college town, having the live show, spending the night there, and then driving back the next day, because I do want to spend as much time as possible at my parents' house, because once the semester starts for me on the 18th, I'm going to be incredibly busy, and who knows when I can come to see them. Like, it's going to be, I'm bunkering down. I only have like one semester yet left on campus, and then the next semester I go into clinical teaching, and so like, this semester is going to be hecka crazy. I was like, I'm going to spend time here as much as possible. So I was like, going to stay there up until the 18th. But since I woke up incredibly dizzy and not feeling well at all, my parents were like, you are not driving, which I didn't want to anyway. So I told them how like this was really important to me. I really wanted to be a part of this live show. And like I've been anticipating this. Like, I've been looking forward to this for so long. Ever since Jen like asked me to do this, I've been like incredibly excited. Like, Jen knows, like when she told me, I was freaking out because I was so excited to do this, to be a part of this. My dad very graciously drove around their town. By the way, they don't have like good Wi-Fi at their house, so that's why I couldn't do it at their house, because their Wi-Fi is really bad. They live in the bum country nowhere of Texas. And so they do have a little small square town, and so we went and drove around in there, and we found a little parking lot that I could sit in that had good service for my phone, where I could hook up a hotspot. I only told them I could be there for an hour because I was trying to be not sit up for a long time. I'm trying to recline as much as possible, and so I was just sitting in the car. I told Jen I could only be there for an hour. Also, I could only rent out my dad as my chauffeur for an hour. He had his headphones in the car, not listening to me or the live show, and then I had my headphones in. He couldn't listen to me anyway. It was an adventure, though. It was an experience. But I'm so incredibly grateful that I got to chat with them for an hour. It was really cool learning about their writing process as a author duo. I am baffled by how, like, authors can write together, just because, like, I want everything to go my way kind of person. Whenever I do write something, I would find it incredibly hard to have a co-author. But again, that's just my personality with writing and stuff. But I thought it was super fun chatting with them, and I'm incredibly grateful that Jen asked me to be a part of this. And I just love their books so much, and I definitely want to read more of their backlist. I told them that I really wanted... I would die for the little novella that I told you about, the, like, 10-page novella at the end of Icebound. Like, I want that whole story. And, like, they told me how it was an inspiration from something else that they did, and it was really cool to talk to them and, like, get into their brains a little bit and just chat with them. I thought it was super fun. I am wanting to read the rest of the Spider's Mate trilogy, though. It's not gonna happen in this video. My brain is not gonna read a book that long, unfortunately, right now, because they were all the people on the live show except for me had read the entire series or written the entire series, and so I felt a little left out. I was like, I need to read these books because they were talking about how amazing they are. I've only read the first book in that series. So anyways, I'm gonna go get ready for bed for the night, and then go to bed, and then I will update you in the last clip of this vlog whenever I do finish Undying.